Once again, I welcome in the course of Geotechnical Engineering 2nd. So in the last class, I have discussed about the compressibility of soil and consolidation. And in compressibility of soil and consolidation, I have discussed what is consolidation and then what is the compressibility and then types of compressibility. And in types of compressibility, I have discussed what is the initial compression and then what is primary and secondary consolidation. And after that, I have discussed the total settlement in a soil, and we have seen that the total settlement is the sum of immediate and primary consolidation and secondary consolidation settlement. And after that, I have discussed the immediate settlement and the expression. We have seen that how to compute the immediate settlement, and we have solved the problem based on the immediate settlement. So today I will discuss the compressibility characteristics and then how to compute the compressibility coefficient, and then I will solve the problem based on the compressibility characteristics and over consolidation ratio. So let us discuss about the compressibility characteristics. So the shape of the curve are related to the stress history of clay. So in compressibility characteristics, generally we draw the virgin compression curve, and the virgin compression curve comes from the consolidation test. And the consolidation test done in the laboratory by the using the odometer apparatus. And once the consolidation test is done, we get the value of void ratio and effective stress. So if I draw the E versus sigma dash curve, so this is on the y-axis the value of void ratio and effective stress. This portion, this is called virgin compression curve. This portion is unloading and then reloading, and where the curvature change, this stress is called pre-consolidation stress, sigma 0 dash. If I draw this diagram in E versus log sigma dash scale, so this is E and this is log sigma dash. So if I draw this and this portion is straight portion, this is recompression curve, this is virgin compression curve, and this portion is called normally consolidated soil, because straight portion, this is called expansion. So same curve I have drawn in E versus log sigma dash scale. So here we can see that once the curvature change, so this value is log sigma 0 dash pre-consolidation stress. What is pre-consolidation stress? I will discuss in the later class, and then how to compute the pre-consolidation stress, that will also I will discuss. Firstly, I will discuss what is normally consolidated soil, and then what is the over consolidation ratio. So the first heading I am going to write, that is over consolidation ratio. Over consolidation ratio, OCR. So it is defined as the ratio of it is the ratio of past overburden pressure that is also called pre-consolidation stress. Pre-consolidation stress to the present overburden pressure or stress acting on the soil. So a soil, whatever the stress experienced in the past and what is the effective stress in the present, that ratio is called over consolidation ratio. So over consolidation ratio can be written as sigma 0 dash past divided by sigma dash present. This is called over consolidation ratio. On the basis of this over consolidation ratio, soil can be classified as normally consolidated, over consolidated or under consolidated. So if the value of over consolidation ratio is equal to 1, means past overburden pressure is exactly equal to the present overburden pressure, then such type of soil is called normally consolidated soil, and it is denoted by NC soil, means sigma 0 dash past is equal to sigma 0 dash present. Means soil is experienced the effective pressure in the past that is equal to the effective stress in the present, then such type of soil is called normally consolidated. If the value of OCR is greater than 1, then such type of soil is called over consolidated soil, also denoted as OC soil. Means, what does it mean? Past overburden pressure is greater than present overburden pressure. Similarly, if the value of over consolidation ratio is less than 1, then such type of soil is called under consolidated. Under consolidated means past overburden pressure is less than present overburden pressure. So here I have written over consolidation ratio. It is the ratio of past overburden pressure or pre-consolidation stress to the present overburden pressure. And if the value of OCR is equal to 1, then such type of soil is called normally consolidated. If OCR is greater than 1, then it is called over consolidated soil. And if the OCR value is less than 1, then it is called under consolidated. Over consolidation is due to the following factor: erosion of soil or melting of ice. So once the erosion is taking place, so soil is experience more overburden pressure in the past as compared to the present, because some parts of the soil is eroded, then stress is get reduced. So if I compute the over consolidation ratio, so it will be greater than 1, so it is over consolidated. Similarly, melting of ice sheet. So once the ice was there, so the stress acting on the soil is more as compared to the once the ice is melted, then stress is reduced. So once again, it is the example of over consolidated soil. So normally consolidated soil is much more compressible as compared to the OC soil. Or we can see that over consolidated soil is just like the dense sand. And the E versus log sigma dash curve for NC soil is always straight line. Here we have seen that in the compressibility characteristics curve, here we can see that it is a straight portion. So normally consolidated soil, the E versus log sigma dash curve is straight line. So if I similarly, if I write E versus log sigma dash curve for over consolidated soil is convex curvature upward. Similarly, E versus log sigma dash curve for under consolidated soil is concave curvature downward. So if I draw the E versus log sigma dash curve, if it is a straight line, so this is for normally consolidated soil. Similarly, if I draw the E versus log sigma dash curve, if it is like that, so it is for OC, over consolidated soil. Similarly, if I draw the E versus log sigma dash curve, and it is like that, so it is for under consolidated soil. So now I am going to discuss the compressibility coefficient. So there are three types of compressibility coefficient. First one is compression index. It is denoted by CC. Second one is coefficient of compressibility. Compressibility denoted by AV, and the third one is coefficient of volume compressibility. It is denoted by AV. So let us discuss one by one. The first one is compression index. Compression index. So compression index is suitable or well defined for the normally consolidated soil. So this term is well defined for normally consolidated soil. And we know that for normally consolidated soil, the curve of E versus log sigma dash is a straight line. It is the slope of a straight portion of E versus log sigma dash curve. So if I draw the E versus log sigma dash curve, this is E log sigma dash, and as I told you, it is the slope of E versus log sigma dash curve for straight portion. So NC soil, for normally consolidated soil, the portion will be straight. I have taken two points. Let us assume this is the void ratio E1. This value is log sigma 1 dash, and this value is log sigma 2 dash e2. So here sigma 1 dash is the effective stress corresponding to the void ratio e1, and sigma 2 dash is the effective stress corresponding to the void ratio e2. So if I take the slope, so theta tan theta, so slope is equal to CC is equal to E1 minus E2 divided by log sigma 2 dash minus log sigma 1 dash. Or we can write CC is equal to change in void ratio divided by log sigma 2 dash divided by sigma 1 dash. So this is the expression of compression index, where E1 is the void ratio corresponding to the effective stress sigma 1 dash. So if I write void ratio corresponding to sigma 1 dash, and E2 is the void ratio corresponding to sigma 2 dash. So this is the slope, and the expression of compression index is delta E by log sigma 2 dash divided by log sigma 1 dash. Let us take the few problems. The result of a consolidation test on a undisturbed soil sample at a depth of 10 meter below the ground level as follows. Pre-consolidation pressure is given 90 kPa. Saturated unit weight of the soil is given 16 kN per meter cube. The water table was encountered at the ground level, assuming the unit weight of water as 10 kN per meter cube, the over-consolidation ratio of the soil. So this is the scenario. Water table at the ground surface. Let us assume this is 10 meters. This point, let us assume A, gamma saturated is 16 kN per meter cube, and pre-consolidation stress is given 90. So we have to present overburden pressure sigma A dash is equal to gamma sat into 10 minus gamma W into 10. So it will be 16 into 10 minus 10 into 10. That is equal to 160 minus 60 kN per meter square. And pre-consolidation stress sigma past is given, that is 90 kN per meter square. So if I compute the over consolidation ratio OCR, so it is the ratio of pre-consolidation stress divided by present effective stress at A. So it will be 90 divided by 60. So this value is 1.5. So OCR is 1.5, that is greater than 1, means if I talk, we can say that the soil is over consolidated soil. So the B option is correct. Similarly, the second question that is asked in GATE 2010, the E versus log P curve shown in the figure is representative of. So I told you that the E versus log sigma dash curve for the normally consolidated soil, it will be straight line. For over consolidated soil, it will be convex curvature upward. And for under consolidated, it is concave concavity downward. So it will be, it is for the over consolidated soil. So B option is correct. Let us take the another problem. that is asked in ESE Engineering Services Examination 2006. In a consolidation test, void ratio decreased from 0.8 to 0.7 when the load was changed from 40 kN to 80 kN per meter square. So what is the compression index? So if I draw the, so this is E and this is log scale log sigma dash. When void ratio is 0.8, when void ratio is 0.8, so the stress is 40 kN per meter square. When void ratio is 0.7, stress is 80. 0.7. So the compression index can be computed as, compression index is the slope of straight portion of E versus log sigma dash. So it will be change in void ratio divided by log sigma 2 dash divided by sigma 1 dash. Or we can write E1 minus E2 divided by log 10 sigma 2 dash divided by sigma 1 dash. So E1 is 0.8 minus 0.7 divided by log 10. It is 80 by 40. 80 by 40. So it will be 0.1 divided by log 2. So the value will be 0.1 by log 2. So it will be 0.332. So if I see the option, so C option is correct. But this parameter, as I told you, that this parameter is well defined for the normally consolidated soil. So CC is well defined for the normally consolidated soil only. Another question that is asked in Engineering Services 2015. The virgin compression curve for a particular soil is as shown in figure on the standard graphical format. The compression index of the soil is, options are 0.3, 0.4, 0.5 and 0.6. So once again, this is the straight portion. Straight portion, so for normally consolidated soil, so slope of this straight portion will give the slope of straight portion of E versus log sigma dash curve will give compression index for normally consolidated soil. So CC is E1 minus E2 divided by log 10 sigma 2 dash divided by sigma 1 dash. So the void ratio is changing from 1.4 to 1. So it will be 1.4 minus 1 divided by log 10. It is 10 by 1. So it will be 0.4 divided by log 10. So it will be, the value is 0.4. So B option is correct. So in the next class, I will discuss the other two compressibility coefficient, that is volume compressibility and coefficient of compressibility.